And turning to our politics lead now, in a major rebuke of the president, his attorney general today says he sees no reason to appoint a special counsel to investigate voter fraud or seize election machines. But as CNN's Joe Johns reports, the president is still unleashing on Twitter today, refusing to accept he lost the election.
The Biden crime family stealing the election. The media is covering up. The Biden crime family stealing this election. The media is covering up. The Biden crime family stealing this election. The media is covering up. We want our freedom for the world. Give us our freedom, Joe Biden. Joe Biden's covering up this election. He's stealing it.
All right. Gotta do something. Hey, V. Sorry, I missed your call there. I was out. I don't get much cell coverage in some of these areas here, and I'm out trying to get some fences mended before we close up for the winter here. So, listen. I'll get back to you later, but I listened to those videos that you sent me, those audios or whatever, the YouTube stuff, and you just cannot get sidetracked. Those are bought and paid for people. Those groups are bought and paid for, and American people are waking up. It's just like barbecue guy. He's out there. He's a neon light to the world. We've got plenty of people that understand what's happened here. The vast majority of American voters know what happened here, but they just have to have a little time for the material to soak in a bit and some of these other revelations come out. We got this, you know, but I understand it's grinding and it's slow. You can't lose your way on this. Just take some deep breaths and, you know, daylight's coming. You know, dark to light. And speaking of which, I only got a few more minutes here before dusk. Let me get back to you a little bit later. You know, I'm thinking about this, what to do, but we'll talk later. All right. Sir, what's up? Good, glad to hear from you. What's going on? You know, I think we saw this coming a very, very long time ago, and of course I've talked about this perfect day we need, and of course you got yours. How's he doing? He's as tough as nails. That's why he's there. But that doesn't make it any easier. You know, he needs his perfect day too, and the whole country needs a perfect day. Something can only really come from God. But I was thinking maybe I could gather a few things together from some of our friends, and it's almost dusk here. I'm just kind of a little bit more to do here. I'll run back to the house. We'll talk soon. All right? Yes, sir. Thank you. All right. Goodbye.
Thank you. Hey, kiddo, how you doing?
Good. Brought you a little something to get for Donald. Here's some homemade peach preserves.
Oh, wow. I will get it to him right away, and I'm sure this will be the makings for a perfect day for kids.
At what?
It's real, and there's more to come out about it. Remember, those servers that were in there, that was a CIA safe house. And those servers were designed to be used to cook elections in other countries, and they've been turned on America.
All right, kiddo, that was fun to get a chance to visit with your listeners. Sorry, it's a little late. Couldn't get done with the legal stuff quite as quick as I wanted to. I'll shoot you an address that you can shoot those macadamia nuts over to the president that you're roasting up, and I know he'll appreciate that you did something special just for him, and encourage him through this moment. And certainly there's, you know, even the people closest to him are pressing him to concede, and that is not what's in the best interest of the country. He knows that, I know that, you know that. It's not an option. Failure here, not an option. He has a little encouragement emotionally, you know, knowing we're back there, and then some good nutrients in those macadamia nuts. I'm sure he'll appreciate that too. I got a storm coming here. You can see by the sunset, it's just spectacular. But I got to get out ahead of it. I don't want to be in the middle of it. I'll tow it like a trailer behind me headed east. Go have some fun. So we'll talk.
Riders on the storm. Riders on the storm. Into this house we're born. Into this world we're thrown. Like a dog without a bone and actor out alone. Riders on the storm. There's a killer.
I cannot and will not accept the theory that long sequences of unrelated accidents determine world events. It is inconceivable that those with power and wealth would not band together with a common bond, a common interest, and a long-range plan to decide and direct the future of the world. I believe, therefore, that a grand game of chess is being played on a level that we can barely imagine, and we are the pawn. Those who have seriously studied history have probably discovered the real reason we go to war on a regularly scheduled basis.
Hey. Yeah, well, you probably hear the hot rod in the background. I'm on my way driving out to D.C. myself. I was hoping to pop in on you there. How's the weather down in Florida right now? Well, I assume you're out there in your pink shorts by the pool just enjoying life and soaking up the sun on your forced vacation. But no, I'm actually headed over to see. I've been listening to a couple of radio shows from my old buddy Bill Cooper and William Cooper, and he and I knew each other as acquaintances back in the late 80s, early 90s, and pretty iconic figure. I'm headed over to pay my respects there to him at his gravesite. And just was listening to some of his old shows, Hour of Time, and what a guy, you know, he, well, yeah, of course, yep, June 28th, 2001, he predicted that Osama bin Laden would be the guy that they would accuse of doing some dastardly deed against a major city, and that after that, the whole world would change, that they'd ramp up surveillance and the government would be become more draconian. You know, he, even before then, I mean, he predicted 9/11 months in advance. He before that, he predicted the school shootings by kids ramped up on psychoactive drugs that would get them ramped up, and they'd be essentially that they would do these school shootings, and then they'd use that as an excuse to go against the Second Amendment. The guy was very perceptive in that way, understood, you know, the big picture in a lot of ways. He wasn't perfect. I knew Bill. He had clay feet, but he did understand in many ways what was going on. He was Navy intel, and, you know, I was one that talked to him about, you know, he wasn't understanding the alien issue, that was part of a scam, and he changed his tune after our conversations back in those days. But he was a seeker of truth, like so many today, and he was my friend, and I miss him.
Sorry.
Oh, Space Jack. Come on, man. Listen, he's a Rockefeller. He's Winthrop Rockefeller's kid. They're cousins.
You don't want any of the, you don't want that recreating, okay?
Listen, Zach, the problem is the post office, they sent the books in these clear covers with President Trump's picture on the back. Some people decided they were going to take a little action behind the scenes. It's the same problem I had with the cookies from your mom. We have the newspaper clippings. They were advertising for women. They got 42,000 women volunteers across Slavic women out of Northern Germany and everywhere, and they put them in submarines and sent them down to Antarctica. 1942. What do you think was going on down there when they got there? Hello, duh. Jacko, something's going on underneath the ice, underneath the covers under the ice. Charles, if you just, it's not that hard. The research is actually pretty simple. Just punch it in. Michael Rockefeller. He didn't die the way they said he died. Crocodiles didn't eat him. He's not a castaway in the family. He's not decided to be a banker. It's kind of a catch me if you can kind of a plot. They're bio machines. They just modify the genetics, but it doesn't mean it has a soul. That's this genetic modification that's done for these types of things. That's, you know, refer to them as the kids because they're just a machine. Okay, but Chris, listen, you're not gonna lift the Titanic off the bottom of the seafloor at this point. But I mean, if you got down there and you photograph in the right spot, you can see the damage. It's the Olympic, not the Titanic. They were switched. You know, they're doing transplants from kids to get the growth hormones and stuff, and then the adrenochrome, and they're trying to stay younger looking, and it's all a scam. Wired magazine's been writing about this. This isn't just fringe stuff. What, you think Wired is fringe? A pastor's wife in Nebraska, the whole world's looking at the crash footage, and she sees divers in the water. She records it. We wouldn't have learned all the rest of this stuff. Hugo, Butterdazillion is like a gift to the country. Judd, it's all about the numbers. Every witch, you know, it's three times everything. That's the maximum power of the spell. Three times they turn in the circle, you know, three times knock, knock, knock on the door. Hello, Osiris number 17. What's the maximum power of the spell? 51. Okay, that's where they do air traffic control for planet Earth from, Area 51. It's part of the magic. These people are a cult. They're a cult with the numbers. Listen, Waco, it's 51 days for the standoff. Why 51 days?
Oh, hey, let me get back to you, bro. We'll talk a little later. All right.
Michael LaVon Robinson. Hello? Everybody knows he's a Baphomet. Monica, please, please, you're hurting my brain. It's obvious. All you gotta do is look at the videos. There's like 50 of them out there. Come on. Aranon, Rhiannon. Your parents were into this Anon thing. No, it's a GMC, not a GMO truck. Well, Samson, listen. Yeah, you get end of the workday on the space station, you just free fall home. That's why you want to do that. You want to be on Space Force building the space station. And you'll wear a titanium suit. Oh, darn, I got your answering machine. Listen, Linda, you got to pick up. You aren't going to believe this. Are you there? All right, I'll go back. But Scott, these people are using fake needles. I mean, they got little caps on the needles. They're not taking the vaccine. They want you to take the vaccine. They know that stuff is crap. Well, Cynthia, because they don't know that the IRS is a Puerto Rican corporation. That's where the checks are going. Come on. This is a scam. It used to be out of the Philippines. L.A., you don't see anything about pygmies and Lilliputians being a problem when the Israelites were going into the promised land. It was giants. I can't believe I've been out of coverage on my cell for, I don't know, like 45 minutes. I thought cells were everywhere out here, but Richard, stop. What do you mean stop? I can't afford to slow down. You need to catch up. And it's not just about draining the swamp. First, you gotta flood the swamp. One flush isn't going to do it. Yeah, Paul, I'm glad for the invitation. But I don't know if I want to go hang out with that good old boy clubs of attorneys and secret handshake clubs. I mean, I know the game. Let's talk energy and we'll see if we make it work. I just don't want to do it in that kind of a gathering. Okay? the scriptures says that when people are under a curse, when they're out of step with God in heaven on the way they conduct their lives, they can lay up wealth and treasure, but it's like putting money in a bag with holes in it. You can stuff it full of stuff, but you're just leaving a trail of money as you go. We've been doing something like that here in America. Something's wrong. We work hard. We accomplish great things. The people are smart. They're not dumb. And yet, we're acting dumb. Dumb to the curse that lies on the land from some events that have been not dealt with, not reconciled. When a murder occurred in a land, until the murderer was found, until he was prosecuted, till judgment was brought to the situation, justice, the crops wouldn't do well, the rain wouldn't come, and it was widely understood, widely recognized that you had to bring justice to that situation. One of the other scriptures that comes to mind, who will be valiant for justice's sake? We have a whole country full of people that are satisfied just being observers. This stolen future that we have lost, all the promises, the beautiful things that we saw that we were going to enjoy and accomplish in our generation, stolen from us. I hear people all the time, oh, we went to the moon. All we've been doing ever since is going in circles, round and round and round and round. Never a straight answer about what's really going on. Big doors turn on tiny hinges. On this one event, generations have been lost. How do we break a curse? What's required? Justice. Those that have blocked us from identifying and apprehending the criminals behind the murder, not just of an individual who had great influence here in America, but across the world. The coup had been going on for a long time. The preparations, the stealing of America, the cutting of holes into the bag where we keep our wealth, that had been greatly perfected over generations, but the final dagger into the side, into the heart of America, was one murder. From that location, all of those dark angels have gone out, restrained, choked, bound America from doing that which was its destiny. Our future was stolen from us by men artfully protecting their own interests, selling their souls, enslaving their fellow man for their own gain in this world, with no thought to the next. There are many who are called to break this curse, like sentinels who've observed and now are ready to act. Those that do act right now, who step their foot forward, you know, Abraham, everywhere that he went, it said wherever he laid the sole of his foot, that was given to him. So we go and stand, occupy, own our ground, and not give it over, not give up, not turn our head the other direction, not ignore that justice has not been done. I'm headed to D.C. I got room in the passenger seat. You can ride shotgun. Who will be valiant for justice's sake?
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.
What you say, but I just can't make a sound. You tell me that you need me, then you go and cut me down. But wait, you tell me that you're so. turn around and say, hey, that it's too late to apologize.
Hey, Victor, I'm just around the corner. Just hang tight a second. I should be there momentarily. Obviously, I got a tight schedule here, but I really needed to grab this for you. It'll be great to throw in the duffel bag for things for the president there. He needs to know more about your story, and I'm thinking of Jaime, your partner, and we're coming up on the anniversary of his passing. The whole country needs to know about that, and besides that, I hope you're feeling well rested and enjoyed your brief retirement. I think the country needs you, Kai, and you need to be ready to get back to work. So I'll see you shortly.
Hey, Juan, it's great to see you. Thank you so much for doing this. Here's a copy of my book for President Trump. I also have a copy for your sign here for you.
Oh man, thanks, guy.
Please tell President Trump that I'm ready to come serve him and our country, and I'm looking forward to it.
All right, bro.
Appreciate
it. Guy.
Thank you.
All right.
Alan, you got to listen to me. It's a violation of the Sherman Antitrust Act. Okay, it's not a parking violation. It's a bank robbery. Big difference. This is a criminal monopolization. It's cartelization. That's what's going on here. If you just start a court action, even a RICO, and then you're just fighting it for the next 5-10 years, they're gonna steal so much money. By the time you get done, they're gonna give a couple $1 million fine. It's asinine. Google, and they want total dominion. It's just like the Dominion voting machine. They want to dominate us. They want to turn us into serfs. Come on, man. This is elites that are being lawless, and we have to come against it in a legal framework. There needs to be preliminary injunctions. Look, you're living in Sodom, okay? Down there in LA, you think that it's safe there? You got to wake up. Be Lot. Don't be Lot's wife. You got to get the hell out of Dodge, dude. Come on. Oh, crap. You know, I'm out here. I got to get back to you here, guy. I just realized I have a problem. All right. I'll talk to you later. Oh, boy. Dear Donald and Melania, Bonnie's Peach Preserve. Oh boy. Wrong jar. Okay. Let me call Bonnie, see if I can solve this problem.
Leave your name and phone number after the beep.
Oh, Bonnie. Hey, I got a problem. Something's come up. It's kind of a emergency, kind of a national emergency. I can't really explain it to you, but you suppose you could send another jar of those peach preserves. I'll send Jim over to maybe grab them for me right away to get them to me. He's flying out to D.C. here. And I sure appreciate it. Okay. Bye.
If an article online uses language that makes you feel angry or scared, it's probably intended to change what you think or feel. How can you know what or who to trust? Look for a few red flags. Check the sources. Trustworthy articles will tell you where they get information. You may not be able to trust what they're saying.
Joey, slow down. Wait. Just because a lot of airplanes are flying doesn't mean everybody's going to Gitmo this second. Okay, Jerry. You were a chief of police for a long time. You heard from John about what was said in New York. So how many sources removed is this? Mary, slow down. What's the source on that? Who said that? Cliff. I'm not looking for a feeling. I just want the data. I don't want to hear what his sister's neighbor said. Frank, come on. Something's screwy here. I'm not buying it. Your neighbor's a great car mechanic. He works for the tire shop. He's not a stockbroker. I think he's being scammed. Get me to the original source on this. History of man. Going back to Egypt and Babylon earlier, Rome, all the royal families, the bloodlines, this elite class that's this corporate technocracy intends to rule the world and make us all their slaves, their sheep, because we need to be managed. That's the history of mankind. One group seeking to gain control over the others. To manage them. Slavery can take a lot of forms. Those chains and bonds aren't always iron. They can be tax law. They can be all sorts of government statutes and rules and licensing. Everything has got to be controlled and managed to the last detail. At the very beginning of the whole thing, they told us you weren't going to stop the virus. It was only about slowing down the rate of infection. Now you got people believing this is all about not catching the virus. You're going to catch the virus. And we come back to dividing, you know, those that'll wear the mask versus those that won't. Dividing the country. Just a few years ago, they were trying to divide us. Manson wants the blacks against the whites. And he's going to try to create a race war. Right back to BLM today. People being paid to go against the interests of their own people. Some of the most inspired speech ever made by any man on this planet. But those words were so true. They rang so true that it changed the world. Started a movement, started a momentum that's still present today. But even now, it's a distant sound. I'm not going to fight my brother. Whatever his race, whatever his religion, I'm going to be my brother's brother, not my brother's keeper. And we're going to go together and kick these people out of our country that seek to enslave us by any means. I'm going to climb that mountain and enjoy the dream together.
We've got some difficult days ahead, but it really doesn't matter with me now, because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place.
Anybody here see my old friend Martin? Can you tell me where he's gone? He freed a lot of people, but it seemed good they die young. I just look around, he's gone. Didn't you love the
thing? I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over, and I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
It's not just me or a couple of guys going back to D.C. It's the whole country going to D.C. to take the country back. We're not going to let the steal of the election stand. If the bank robbers get out of the bank and they get in the getaway car and they get around the corner, do we say, oh, darn, they got away, and let them take the money and keep it? Are you kidding me? We're going to hunt them down, rope them off. They can either surrender or not, but they're not going to keep the money. They're not going to let the theft stand. We're taking our country back. We're all showing up. It seems like I know about five Larrys all live in Arkansas. There must have been like some great Larry back there that everybody's paying homage to. But no, I'm talking about Larry Nichols. I know he's struggling a little bit. Could you get a message over to him that just wanted to send a little love his way? And I sure appreciate he's done so much to bring light to what had been going on before the Clintons came into the big spotlight and made a lot of sacrifices, more importantly, his family. You know, feel for all of them, and I know they didn't really want to be in the spotlight. I thought I'd drive by the Clinton Library here. I'm just wondering, after they rewrite history and expose all the lies, what's going to be left in that library to show that has anything to do with the truth? There's a double meaning to library. Sure, baby. I just want to be president. And then he was. And then during the inauguration, he's given all this credit to Carol Quigley, who wrote his book about tragedy and hope, and how all the secret societies and secret families that were hidden throughout history had been, you know, building to this moment in time. And that Bill, the reason that he understood and was able to become president is because of Carol Quigley's teaching. Bill wasn't lying about their secret little cabal and clubs, their globalist ideals. That's the one thing he wasn't lying about. Look, the truths, the revelations brought out by people like Larry and others, Patterson, all the others, that it may not have been heard at the time. It may not wanted to have been heard. It may not have been acted on. They might have got away with it for a period of time, but justice is coming. It's not far off. These illusionists twisting reality. Justice is coming. The truth bell's going to ring. victory is just around the corner. Thank God for President Trump.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life. And I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I'd thank my lucky stars to be living here today, where the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away.
Texas, oh, from sea to shining sea,
from Detroit down to Houston,
and New York to LA,
where there's pride in every American heart,
and it's time we stand and say.
You have to pick a lane, heaven or hell, right or wrong, left or right. It was said in Germany, in those towns near the concentration camps, when the trains were coming by loaded with people going to the death camps, that the people in the churches heard the trains coming, the moaning of the people. What did they do about it? They sang louder. Maybe if you sing louder, you won't hear the flames and the torment at the gates of hell as you ride in. Pick a lane, but pick the right lane. We certainly don't need everybody to show up necessarily. We just need those that are called, and we'll win. I don't want to show up with a bunch of 501c3 approved people to stand there in some milquetoast way and say what's only politically correct at the most critical time in American history. I want to stand there with real patriots that could give a flying whatever about what some government stooge from some approved agency going to give me a tax what? For what? To shut me up? President Trump is a two-term president. Get on the right side of history. The steel is not going to stand. People are going to prison, but it won't be Trump. They're the ones going to jail. Take it to the bank.
It's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Because you'd be in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
Oh, hey, bud. That was fun getting to cross paths over there at the Trump there with Glenda and Gloria. And that was such a blast. We're running a little low on good guys. Might need to fill out the ranks a little bit. You ready to get back to work? Yeah, well, you know, with your history, I mean, the family, Fort Bliss named after one of the family members, and I think first Congressional Medal of Honor winner. That's pretty impressive. But you yourself, look, there's something there in your bloodstream. You're my kind of guy, and I think we got a slot for you. So get well. I'll help you get back to work. I'll tell the guys keep a place at the table for you. Thanks. Oh yeah, no. I know you love the president. That's why we went. That's why you're over at the Trump Hotel with me. Yeah, I'll convey that. All right. Talk soon. Bye.
Mr. President, I would like to present this to you. I was one of your strongest supporters from early on. Before you became president, I supported Donald J. Trump. And the background on this. As I was visiting my good friend, King Abdullah in Jordan, I was introduced to the British ambassador. I had this as a gift for King Abdullah. He introduced me to the British ambassador, and the ambassador said, "What is that?" And I said, "Well, sir, with this." And sir, I also want to present you with the challenge coin. This is an arrowhead. It's symbolic of the special forces, of which I was a member. And I wish you good luck and Godspeed and kick ass.
Yes, sir. Yes, it's being prepared right now. We'll have it for you shortly. I'll be right there. All right, bye.
But I am sending him this beautiful handmade that he can put on his desk to remember SEAL Team and how much we love him. Been the greatest present in my lifetime. To see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall. All you have to do is call. And I'll be there. Yes, I will. Now, ain't it good to know? When people can be so cold, they'll hurt you, yes, and desert you, and take your soul if you let them. Oh, but don't you let them. You just call. Because we fight for it. We die for it. The last thing that I want is to tell my children's children what the United States and freedom used to look like. And I can't claim that one because one of the fallen heroes of this republic, President Ronald Reagan, said that. And we're not too far from an eternal flame where another dead soldier, President John F. Kennedy, and I believe Trump is the next Kennedy. Except he's going to live on. He's going to live in the annals of history. So guys, let's level up right now. We owe it to our children. We owe it to our flag. We owe it to the Vietnam Memorial. We owe it to the souls that are 6 feet under. God bless you guys. Let's level up for freedom. Semper Fi. God.
departed Attorney General William Barr, who scorched the president, saying, quote, orchestrating a mob to pressure Congress is inexcusable. The president's conduct yesterday was a betrayal of his office and supporters. Even his staunch supporter and golfing partner, Lindsey Graham, pulling the ripcord on the president.
Is count me out. Enough is enough. I've tried to be helpful. When it's over, it is over. It is over.
And a number of administration officials resigning in the wake of yesterday's violence, including the special envoy for Northern Ireland, Mick Mulvaney. He was also White House chief of staff. Stephanie Grisham, the first lady's chief of staff. Matt Pottinger, the deputy national security.
Sir, I have the items we discussed. Gifts from friends of the president. The makings for a perfect day. Where we go one, we go all. Godspeed.
Maybe this was foolish, but I really meant it. That someday I'd like to maybe lose everything for a period of time to see who's loyal and who's not loyal. And I frankly, I found out a lot of things.
Did you find out who's loyal and not loyal?
I tell you what, and you can't guess it. You can't predict it. You think certain people would be loyal no matter what.
The acting DHS Secretary Chad Wolf says he will stay in his position until the end of the administration, but also calling on the president to do more to denounce the violence, in a statement saying, quote, what happened yesterday was tragic and sickening. I implore the president and all elected officials to strongly condemn the violence. Not long after that statement was put out by Chad Wolf, the White House informed us that his nomination to be permanent Secretary of Homeland Security had been withdrawn from the Senate, but the Deputy Press Secretary, Judd Deere, insisting that was mere coincidence. In a statement to Fox News, Deere saying, quote, the withdrawal occurred yesterday.
Founder Mark Zuckerberg just has put out a statement as well, now saying that the president, after being banned on Twitter, is now banned indefinitely on Facebook as well. He put out a statement saying that he believes the risks of allowing the president to continue using our...
Antifa told their followers that they needed to infiltrate the Patriot movement, to infiltrate the supporters of President Trump. Repeatedly, Patriots saw the Antifa people for who they were, tried to warn people off, tried to stop them when they were busting out the windows. But they got in, they're actors, they're paid actors, and they staged events that were recorded and sent out to the world as though that was the president's supporters doing those evil deeds. They weren't. They'll be discovered in time. In time.
Release the spirit of encouragement on all who are here. I want to release the power of encouragement in your ears. Be exhorted in Jesus' name. Be encouraged in Jesus' name. The times we're in seem like there's no going back. The things we're hearing about, the Lord has spoken of. There's no surprises in the kingdom. You were made for this hour. You were made to stand strong. You were made for this time. You were made to sing. You were made to fight. You were made to worship with all your might. You were made for the glory. For this time. calling the fathers, calling the fathers. You know war very clearly, we're calling the fathers. Calling you to the young ones, to the young hearts. The spirit of Elijah's been released upon the land. The spirit of Elijah means John the Baptist is here again. Calling in the wilderness, prepare the way. Prepare the way, for the King is coming again. We're getting ready now, getting ready for that day. The song is called Come, Come, Come. It's time to call him in.
Come, 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 all you who are lost. Oh, come, come,
That was an experience. More bends and twists and turns than an anaconda. Of course, we're down there with the streets that are anacondas, I guess. Taking our country back, obviously. And I think all the guys that thought they had to leave the country to get safe when the Democrats were coming into power, when Hillary was coming into power, Biden coming into power, and now we know that that actually, America is going to be the place that's the refuge, that we're taking our country back. And that's actually pretty invigorating. We're going to get this thing back on track. I can feel it. I see that the people are waking back up and the numbers are there with us to get things under control. And, you know, it's an end of one thing, but it's the start of another. It's a jubilee. It's a restart. It's a refresh. And I'm going to come home. I'm going to rest up. It's been months and months getting here and years. But it's time to get started, get back to work. I'll get a good sleep in and see you shortly. Yeah, no, I'm on my way. I just topped off on the fuel, and I've been on the road for a while. Huh? No, who would have thought that macadamia nuts and peach preserves would go together? That was like, give me a break, dude. You know those Secret Service guys weren't going to let any of that get through to the president. Yeah, the other stuff, they can scan and probe and ray and everything. No. Some guy was going to be eating that stuff his office for lunch one day. The president wasn't getting it. He still got some of those nuts still left there. That Roseanne won't care. She's got a whole freaking orchard full of them. It was symbolic, okay? That's what the whole point was. Thank you.
Oni, I've got some great news. You know how you've been wanting to go for a ride in the Aston? You're kind of tired of the truck at this point in time, and I always tell you, no, no, no. Okay, so we're going to take a road trip. We're taking the Aston. Well, yeah, that's the good news. The president needs a friend, and you've been volunteered. The bad news is, yeah, we're not going to Mar-a-Lago. We're going to D.C. Oni? Oni, come back here. Oni, come back here. Oni, come back here. Sometimes you have to take one for the team. Now, come on, get out from underneath the bed. Sometimes dogs are smarter than people.